Let's take a look at outliers. Suppose you have temperatures, body temperatures of 130 healthy adults, and we look at those in Stapplet. With the dot plot, we can see that there's definitely at least one point that's far removed from the rest of the data. And the definition for an outlier is technically a data point that is significantly different from the other data points. There's in words up above here, there's kind of a formula for it. I put that in the notes and cheat sheet. In this is in section 2.3. That is the formula that we want to use. So we need to find the IQR. That's basically the distance across the middle 50% of data points. So we sort of define the spread of the data by that middle 50%. So think about like half the data points in the middle. We're saying that's kind of our standard for how spread out this thing will be. And if we inflate that by 50%, that's the 1.5 times IQR. Imagine that distance multiplied by 1.5, and then we extend it from the two sides. And that's kind of what gonna look like, what a box plot looks like, really. But what we're saying is take this, multiply by 1.5 and extend it, and that will give us a cutoff. And so I'm guessing that we're gonna have a cutoff that lands right in here somewhere. It's not gonna be outside of that maximum. Same thing here. So let's take a look at the numbers and the formula. Start with Q1 minus 1.5 times IQR. That's gonna be the Q1, 97.8 minus 1.5 times IQR. I'm gonna do that in parentheses. A lot of people will do this first, but you can do it all at once. That's Q3, 98. 0.7 minus Q1, which is 97.8. It's a little interesting to me. We think of 98.6 as kind of like that healthy temperature, and we see that 98.6 is actually kind of a little bit above the median for this group. So anyway, what we have now is Q1 minus 1.5 times the IQR, Q3 minus Q1, and that gives us a lower fence is a term for that. And that's going to be a cutoff. Anything below that lower fence will be considered an outlier. And the minimum, 96.3, is below the lower fence of 96.45. So 96.45 is about right here. We end up with the two smallest data points being outside of that lower fence, and those are outliers. Now, this is called the whisker, and that's probably going to just be the next lowest data point. So here we have 100 is the second highest, and then on the upper fence, let's calculate that. That's Q3 plus, so 98.7 plus this same figure from here. So I'm just going to copy and paste that without the minus. Upper fence is 89.05. I did something wrong. This is 90. I did 87.7. This is 98.7. Okay. So the upper fence is 100.05. That's right here, just a little bit past that 100. So this is the second highest data point is within the fence. We'll have the whisker end there. And then this maximum of 100.8 out here is an outlier. So it's important to note that if you start with a dot plot, the dot farthest to the left, or excuse me, if you start with a box plot, the dot farthest to the left will be the minimum, the dot farthest to the right will be the maximum. It doesn't matter that they're outliers, they are still the max and min. Now I'm going to start over with this other data set. This is a heart rate, and quickly just change my numbers and see a little different example. This one doesn't quite look like it has outliers, but let's take a look at the box plot. Correct. So this is a great example of one that does not have outliers. So let's start with the lower fence here. The lower fence is Q1 69 minus 1.5 times Q3 minus Q1. So those are the Q1s. Another one here. And then the Q3 is 79. That's going to be here, here, and here. Lower fence is 54. Minimum is 57. So the lower fence, we got the minimum is 57. We're not going to put it as a dot because it's inside that fence. Upper fence is 94. Maximum is 89. So the 89 is the max there, upper fence is past it. The whole thing sits within that fence. And so you can kind of see how that, it could very well be an outlier if you just went by the image. But if we go with the numbers, that's going to give us a more consistent result.